want another chance to see the party? Well, don't worry, because now you have another chance to see the party live on stage when they hit the road again with an all-new party tour.
I can't hide this emotion. Let me tell you that I found love.
This week, the party will be jamming at these concert locations. Keep watching for further party updates. Have you ever dreamed of being a Mouseketeer? Well, this could be your chance. The Mickey Mouse Club casting call is on the road, and we'll be stopping on Saturday, November 3rd in Cleveland at the Sheraton Cleveland City Center Hotel from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Then on Sunday, November 4th, we'll hit Pittsburgh at the Westin William Penn from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. If you're between 11 and 14 and wish to audition, bring a cassette of your music accompaniment and be prepared to sing and dance. So stay tuned for more updates on the Mickey Mouse Club casting call. Listen up, America. Your favorite Mickey Mouse Club Mouseketeers are coming out to meet and greet you. It's all happening at the JCPenney stores and malls all over the country. Plus, while you're there, sign up for the nationwide casting call for new Mouseketeers. Pittsburgh, the Mouseketeer meet and greet is coming to you. Be there Saturday, November 3rd at the Ross Park Mall from 10:30 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. At the Monroeville Mall from 1:30 p.m. to 2:30 p.m. And at the Century 3 Mall from 3:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m.
Hey, this next one's so hot.
The following presentation is closed caption for the hearing impaired.
Welcome to the Mickey Mouse Club.
It's Monday, Music Day, and today's Music Day guest is here to sing his hit song, Don't Shut Me Out, Kevin Paige.
We'll be opening some more of your mouse mail, and we've also got the next episode of our club movie, My Life as a Babysitter.
But first, it's time for this special Mickey Mouse Club announcement.
Throughout the ages, man has dreamed of flight. At the turn of the century, many inventors attempted to fly, but their experiments ended in failure after failure. At last, in 1903, the Wright brothers succeeded at Kitty Hawk, but they were not the first to design a practical flying machine. That honor belongs to young Scott Beckett, who invented the paper airplane in 1791. For 200 years, there has been little advance in paper airplane technology. Until now. This Friday, the Mickey Mouse Club will attempt to launch a really big paper airplane, the Loose Leaf, from the Eiffel Tower at the Disney MGM Studios theme park. Don't miss this historic event.
That's right, you definitely don't want to miss this Friday's historic launch of the really big paper airplane.
And of course, we still have a full week ahead. So let's start the week off just right by going on this double date.
Well, here I am. Where are the girls?
They'll be here any minute.
Now, are you sure they're Cinderella's sisters?
Yep,
And you know how cute Cinderella is.
Oh, yeah!
So her sister's a baby.
Fine. Ooh. Hey, is that them?
I think so. Hey, girls, over here.
Were you peasants speaking to us?
Yeah, I'm Bob Woolsey, and this is my friend, Bert Wheeler. You must be Anastasia and Drizella. Hi there.
What a crass vulgarian.
Thanks.
Ew.
I'm glad you can make it.
No thanks to you.
I thought you were going to send a coach to pick us up.
I did.
Hey, I'll be back at 10 to take you two meatballs home, okay?
Thanks, coach.
You got it.
Oh, this is going to be awful, just awful. They're so coarse.
Are you sure they're friends with the prince?
Yes.
So we're just going to have to make the best of this loathsome situation.
Give us the pork rind.
Ew!
Oh, I feel faint.
What is this place, anyway? I thought we were going to the ball.
The ball? Oh, no, no, no. What I said was, we're going bowling. Bring your own ball.
Oh, so sorry. We didn't bring any bowling balls.
What a shame.
Oh, well, we'll have to be going for the night.
Good night.
Oh, hey, don't split it. You can have one of these. Here.
Oh.
Oh. Perfect. Come on, let's bowl.
Not no shoes.
And what's wrong with our shoes?
They're custom made.
Who wears a big foot?
He means you could get hurt in those heels. We'll get you the right shoes.
New shoes? Wonderful. See if they have anything in glass.
Glass?
Glass.
I think they like us.
Can you believe those two?
Oh, they're so, so good.
Common.
Let's escape before they come back.
We're back!
Oh, hello.
We got the shoes, and we picked up some fun soda as well. Want a swig?
Please, I've never swigged in my life.
May as well get this over with.
Well,
that's not what I meant.
Put the shoe on my foot.
I don't think this is your size.
Yes, it is. I know it is. Just push harder.
This isn't working.
Maybe you need a shoehorn.
Maybe I need a crowbar.
Got it. I don't believe it's over.
Now the other one.
Oh.
There. They go great with your dress.
Don't patronize me. Just fetch me one of those balls and let's get this over with.
Okay, Driz. It's easy. All you gotta do is take this ball, roll it down the alley, and whammo.
Sounds jolly.
Go do it.
If I must.
There. Now may I go?
No.
This time, let's try hitting the pin. Here, let me show you.
Come on, curve, baby, curve.
Yes, another try. It brings the win.
I'm hot tonight. Give me those pork rinds, Bubbo.
Great, Driz. You're a shoo-in to win tonight's high score trophy. Okay, Bert, it's your turn.
Can we at least try another size?
I told you I'd take a 5. Try harder.
Ladies and gentlemen, Fiesta Lanes is proud to present the winner of tonight's high score trophy.
Oh, way to go, Driz.
The winner is a newcomer, a pretty little lady who is bowling her first game tonight. Let's give a big hand to Princess Cinderella.
What? Not again.
Sorry, girl. Better luck next time.
Ooh, I wish I had a fairy godmother.
Don't worry about it. You did great.
What do you say we all go out for some pizza?
That'll be cool.
Guys?
Ah, did it. Fine, let's go.
We'll take them off now.
Oh.
Time once again for Mouse Mail, part of the show where we answer actual mail from club members at home.
And our first letter is from Melissa Dillon from Brooklyn, New York. And Melissa writes, Dear Mickey Mouse Club, I'd like to ask if you ever get sleepy on the show.
Why, yes, Melissa, sometimes we do get sleepy on the show. Isn't that right, Sleepy? Sleepy?
Hmm? Hi-ho, hi-ho, it's off to sleep we go.
Thanks, Sleepy. Tune in next time. We might have Dopey or Doc.
Our next letter is from Julia Prang, a club member in Petaluma, California. And Julia asks, Dear Mickey Mouse Club, I watch your show every day. What is the biggest mistake you've ever made?
See, that's hard to say.
Yeah, but it was probably
the time Fred was on with Bill Nye.
Fred, today we're going to do an experiment that's somewhat dangerous, so kids, please, don't try this at home. Put all the green liquid into the test tube.
Uh-huh. Now, Bill, can I just shake this?
Oh, Brent, don't do that!
It's so boom.
Remember, if you have any comments or questions about the Mickey Mouse Club, just send them to...
Mouse Mail, Mickey Mouse Club, Disney MGM Studios, Post Office Box 10200, Lake Buena Vista, Florida, 32830. And if we read your letter on the show, you'll get one of our Mickey Mouse Club t-shirts.
It's time for our club movie. Here's episode 7 of My Life as a Babysitter.
Your babysitting empire, Nikki?
Yeah, that's very funny. As a matter of fact, I'm helping Jennifer out. Her dad's real sick or something.
Is that right?
You know, I know you always make fun of this class I'm taking, Mitch, but it just so happens that Jennifer and I are very tight because of it.
Really?
So what are you guys doing?
We're just hanging out, Kramer, you know? It's what... some of us refer to as a social life.
But it's not like a date thing.
Ow!
Ah! Oh! Hey. No harm done. Look, we don't need a second pizza. Why don't you guys take it, right? No sense having to wait around. It's pepperoni. You like pepperoni, Alyssa? That's great. Here you go, Nick. Should we settle up tomorrow? Yeah? No, I insist, okay?
Okay, well, tomorrow.
No problem, yeah.
Hey, thanks.
No problem, yeah, great. Listen, I was going to call you last night when I got home, but it was kind of late and I didn't want to disturb your dad or anything. I mean, how's he doing?
He's fine.
He's fine, but I thought...
Yeah, it's a miracle or something.
Isn't modern medicine amazing?
Well, thanks for last night.
Bye!
Girls, what do they want? And Jennifer, there I was turning myself into Mr. Sensitive and the champion babysitter of all time, and it was getting me nowhere. On top of that, I was spending all my afternoons with a 9-year-old whose greatest pleasure in life, besides climbing trees, was busting my chops. Let me put it this way. Things were not turning out the way I'd expected. Hey, Ben. Ben.
Birth to Ben. Something wrong?
Mm.
You want to talk about it?
Mm-mm.
What's that?
It's from my dad.
What?
It's a letter from my dad.
Bad news?
He promised I could stay with him over Thanksgiving. Oh, he says I can't.
Timing's just not going to work out this time. Hope you're not too disappointed. There's always Christmas. Dad. I'm kind of disappointed in some of myself right now. This is lousy, doesn't it?
This isn't just someone. It's my dad.
I know. I'm sorry. You know, when I was a kid, and I was feeling down like this, there was this secret place that I would go to. It wasn't much, really. It was just this... just this place at the end of my street. A bunch of bent over trees would come together and make kind of a fort. It was my fort. Nobody knew about it but me. Of course, it's gone now. They built houses on it or something. What?
I have a place like that.
You do?
It's not a fort, but it's mine. Even as a name.
Yeah.
Florida.
Florida.
Yeah. You want to see it?
Yeah. I like that.
Hey!
Come on up!
Up there?
What are you waiting for?
Nothing. I just feel a little dizzy when I look down, that's all.
So look up. Someday, I want to climb this tree all the way to the top. It's the biggest, best tree in the world. No, it's kind of old. And when I get to the top, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to build a brand new tree house. Way up there in the sky, like it's floating. Nobody can see me. I can see the whole world.
Sounds good, Ben. I remember lying there in that treehouse with Ben and thinking how quickly things could turn around. There had been just a half an hour before feeling like my life couldn't get any worse. And now things were great. But if I'd known what was going to happen next with Jennifer, I probably would have wanted to stay in that treehouse forever.
Here, Linda, have a chocolate.
Thanks, Larry.
Has this ever happened to you? You're offered a free chocolate, and you want a really good one, but you can't tell by looking at them just what's inside. It could be something wonderful like a caramel. Or it could be...
Ooh, lemon mint! Gross!
Excuse me, I'll just keep my chocolates to myself.
Not only have you just eaten a bad chocolate, you've just made an enemy for life. Well, this will never happen again when you buy the new Candytector from Mouseco. Here's how it works. The next time you're offered a box of unknown chocolates, just take out your Candytector and hold the detection coil 1 to 2 inches above the chocolates. And the Candytector will do the rest.
Caramel, my favorite! Gee, thank you, Larry.
Don't get in a chocolate mess. Buy the new Candytector from Elsco.
Today's music day guest has created his own style in the music business. It's called Pop, Rhythm, and Blues.
Here to perform his exciting single, Don't Shut Me Out, please welcome Kevin Paige.
Don't shut me out. Don't shut me out. Don't shut me out.
A great song.
Thank you very much.
Now, I understand that you play a lot of instruments, but about how many instruments do you play in all?
About four, maybe five, I don't know. I play the drums, bass, keyboards, and a little bit of guitar.
Well, since you can only play one instrument at a time, how can you play an entire song?
Well, when you cut a record, it's like cutting with 32 different tape machines. You got different tracks, and you just kind of do one, then top it with another.
So it's really step by step.
Put the band together, yeah.
Okay, now this is also your first album, and basically you wrote the whole thing by yourself. How do you decide what to write about?
I just pretty much write about everyday experiences that I go through, you know. Whereas as now it's kind of hard to write because we're on the road so much that there's not too many experiences going on.
Well, thank you very much for being with us today.
All right, thank
you. And everybody, let's give a big round of applause for Kevin Paige and the band.
See you real soon.
Why? Because we like you.
Mouse Club is videotaped before a live audience at the Disney MGM Studios in Lake Buena Vista, Florida.
On the northern.
Yeah! It's guest day on the all-new